Hello, young explorers. How are you all? My name is Dinesh Nissan, and today we will discuss very important concept with which you encounter daily. Thanks to braking system of car, which saved my life. Many a times, you experience this. Even when you are riding bicycle, you put on brakes. We have brakes on all vehicles, whether it may be a bicycle or aeroplane. Yes, aeroplane also have brakes. But we will not talk about brakes of aeroplane, but a braking system on road. If you have observed keenly how your bicycle brake works, just recall or go and see how your bicycle brake works. That is different thing. In braking system of car or truck, the vehicles which are running on road, they have different mechanism in braking. Even nowadays, you might have read three letters on cars when you buy new car. Any guess what are those three letters? ABS, anti-lock braking system. What is that? We will discuss about ABS system as well. Cars with ABS system are costlier than normal cars. So car comes in normal brake and ABS brake. What is the difference and how it is useful, where it is useful? We will discuss about that. But in previous session, you saw Pascal's law. You learned about YouTube manometer. So today we will be making a model which will tell us how exactly hydraulic brake works. Yes, that is our today's topic, hydraulic brake. What is word mean by hydraulic? If you have seen big truck or your school bus, when any big truck or school bus stops, what happens? While you are stepping down from that bus, what you listen? Psss, a big air sound. What is that? And if you see on the side of your bus, you will read AIR, air. So some buses even today have air brakes. Now I'm talking two concepts, air brake and hydraulic brake. So what is air? Air is also fluid. Even you talk about water, oil or air, all are considered as fluid. So when fluid is in the system, what happens with that fluid, that we will see with some experiments. So, you have such two syringes of 20 ml and 10 ml in your kit and a connecting pipe. I will show you one very simple example of compressed fluid and non-compressible fluid, how they work. So, for that, I'm using for demonstration purpose. This is not provided in the kit. So, if you weigh this block, it is somewhat around 800 gram. So to lift this 800 gram, how much force is required that you can feel when you lift with your hand. Now, I have taken a bottle, any PET bottle, and I filled it with a sand. And I have a hole here. I'm inserting tube from this hole and taking it from this side. I will connect this syringe with it and will fit in this. So just make sure that it is vertical, and then now I will connect another syringe, but only by pulling. Now what is inside this is air. Remember, air is also a fluid. Now I have connected these two cylinders with a enclosed tube. So these two cylinders are connected with a tube and it has air as a fluid in this system. Now, when I press this side, you can see this piston is going upside. Whatever pressure I am applying here, the same pressure is applied here and force is transferred. So if you read here, the same thing. I have a 10 ml syringe. So here you can see the displacement 10. Now, let us put this weight on it. Now I am going to press this syringe. Just keep eye on both the syringes. I am pressing this, nothing is happening at this point. I am pressing this, nothing is happening at this point. Why this piston is not going up? Despite of this syringe or this piston is going down. Because, just keep observing. See, at this point now this piston starts moving. And it is going up. I am able to do some work. So, what was happening? As air is a compressible fluid, air can be compressed. So, your system is doing less work. Less force is transferred. So, to avoid such kind of mechanism where you need greater magnitude of force should be applied on the other side, you need hydraulic system. You must have heard about hydraulic crane, hydraulic jack. So that word hydraulic means what? You might have seen big cranes. They are lifting heavy loads with just one single lever in the hand of driver. And if you see that popular toy, JCB, you must love playing with JCBs. So how that JCB is able to do mammoth of work or tremendous work in just few less time? Because if you see the driver sitting has some levers, he's playing with the levers. And there are some cables running over the arms of JCB, which are connected to the end arm or crane. What is running through those pipes? That is hydraulic fluid, a hydraulic system. And you keep oil in the system. Now, the amount of force or how much work you can do, because the fluids have different texture. So if you use oil, if you use water, your system will perform differently. As oil is viscous, it performs well. So we will see the same system by putting some fluid in it. Now, to put the fluid, we have to use again water. So I am using water in it. So what I am doing here, I am just keep the syringe here. I will fill the complete syringe with water. Remember, there should not be any bubble in your system. Put it here. Now, we have filled this complete tube and syringe with water. I'm just inserting this tube and again by putting. This on it. Just make sure that it is vertically straight. Now, I'm placing this 800 gram block on it. Now, when you just press slowly, now see, this is beauty of Pascal law. वॉट एवर प्रेशर यू आर अप्लाइंग इफ यू हैव अ नॉन कॉम्प्रेसिबल फ्लूइड इन द सिस्टम वॉट एवर प्रेशर यू आर अप्लाइंग एट वन एंड द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर इज ट्रांसमिटेड टू एवरी वेयर इन द फ्लूइड सो इन दिस वॉल दैट इज वाई इट डजेंट मैटर विथ विच साइज यू आर कनेक्टिंग बोथ द सिलेंडर्स इवन यू कैन यूज अ बिगर ट्यूब हियर और स्मॉलर ट्यूब दैट डजेंट मैटर Because whatever pressure you are applying here is equally transferred from one cylinder to another cylinder, whichever tube size or connecting tube sizes, it doesn't matter. So I'm just pressing it. Now you can see. See, even I'm pressing slightly, even this is getting displaced. See. To the fullest. 10 ml here. With such kind of system, you can do tremendous amount of work with less force. So, for example, if you need 10 newtons of force here, you are applying on this piston to put it down. If you put a lever, you have learned about levers. So, to press this directly, you need, for example, 10 newton. Force you require. Even you don't want to put that amount of force on it to get this work done. So what we do, we put a lever here. So which kind of lever is this? Here you have, you're lifting this or pressing this down. So even as long as you go on this side, your efforts will be less. So when you press it here, your amount of efforts took for this work are less. That is why if you have seen a hydraulic jack, now there are two types of hydraulic jack. One is mechanical, where you have to lift the car mechanically by screwing action. And second, we have hydraulic jack, where you have to just like you are kicking your bike. You have to put that lever down. So that lever is lifting with very less amount of force. You can lift the car, which is around 200 kg mass. Is it possible to lift car with your hand? Not possible. But that is possible because of this system. And if you understand Pascal's law, you will see many things around you which are working on Pascal's law. So let us see one more project. That is our today's main topic, is making of a hydraulic brake. How it works, and I told you about ABS system. In normal cars, we don't have that braking system. But how it works, we will see. First of all, we will make a project and then we will see how it works. This is the material required to make hydraulic brake. You will need a screwdriver and 1.5 volt batteries from your house. We have this wooden board, a wheel, two wooden blocks having one hole on this surface. So you will find the same hole on opposite side, and there is one hole at the bottom. Then we have this plastic clamp and three nut bolts, one extra is given. So you will use this nut bolt with to fix this bracket. Then we have three screws, which you will use with this wooden batten to fix on a board. One extra screw is there. Then we have this bush. So you will unscrew this and fix it on a board. I will show it later. Then we have battery holder, two syringes, 20 ml, 10 ml, a connecting tube, locking cable tag, motor and a foam with both side tip. First, you need to fix this bushes on this board at four corners. So remove this bolt, insert it from the top side, and from bottom side you just put it and tight it, and finally you can tight it using screwdriver. So such you will fix these four bushes at four corners. In this step, we will fix this 10 or 12 ml syringe on board using this plumbing clamp. So first of all, remove the release paper and paste it at the center of these two holes. So you can see this, it is at the center of these two holes. Then how to put this syringe? Now there are two ways, either you can put like this or you can put like this. Always remember, this piston side will be outside of your board. If you place it like this, it will be wrong. So remember, when you are placing this, this syringe should be or this piston should go outside of your board like this. It will be easy for handling. Then remove this release paper and match this edge with this edge and put it there. So you can see the reading as well. After this, insert this long bolt through the two holes and put it here and insert it through the hole like this. And from bottom side, you will put the nut on it. So put the nut. Similarly for other. Now I'm just pressing with my thumb from this side. So tight it. This is done. If necessary, you can use screwdriver to tight it, but don't tight it too much, otherwise it may break this syringe. After this, these two holes are left on the board. For that, we will use these long screws. What to do? We will insert this screw from this side. It is coming freely. Now we have these two wooden battens. If you see, there are two holes on this side and one hole at the bottom side. So we will fix this here like this. Now initially just tighten it with one or two turns with your finger and then use screwdriver to tighten it. But remember, when you are tightening it, these two holes should come on a longer side. If you tighten it in this way, we have two holes on the shorter side. Remember, these two holes on wooden block should align with the longer line of a board. Even after fixing, you can change it. So that is done. Then fix another wooden block. That's it. After this, so our basic structure is ready. Take this battery holder and motor. Remove this insulation properly. So when you are removing this enamel, just twist it so that all the metal strands will get twisted. Connect these two metal wires with these metal clips on motor. So this is how your two wires will be connected with motor. Make sure that these two metal wires should not touch each other, otherwise it will be short circuit. Now take this board. Remember the orientation. You have syringe on this side. These two towers or wooden blocks are facing each other. Now remove the release paper on the motor. This shaft of a motor will be towards the wooden block like this. Then remove the release paper on battery holder and place it on a floor so that I will show you from this side as well. On the opposite side of a syringe, After this, you will place a wheel on this shaft. And just make sure by if you put the batteries, this so I'm just putting the batteries for testing. Put the negative terminal on spring. So this will start, this wheel will start moving. After putting batteries, if you see such vibrations, I will just show you. See, after putting these batteries, you will see this is moving a lot. I will just switch it off to reduce the noise. So after putting battery, even tightening from the bottom side, this button is moving a lot. So what you can do is, you can take this both side tape, extra both side tape which is given, just make a small piece of it and remove this complete button, put this tape at the bottom and fix it again. Put the tape here, just mark the point and put it on the base and tighten the screw again. We have this 20 ml syringe and a tube. Take some water. Make sure that when you are filling water in the syringe, you should start from the bottom. So make it zero first. Put it in water and slowly pull the piston till the end. Now we will have complete water in your system. By any chance, if you have a bubble like this in your system, so just make it upside down, take this bubble close to this vent and press it gently, so all the bubbles will go outside and you will have complete water in your system. Then attach this tube and slowly, so if you can see here in the water in the tube, I'm pressing it slowly. This water will rise till the end. Now what will happen if I make it upside down? Will this water fall down? What is your call? Let's try this. This water will not fall. Find out a reason why this water is not falling down from the tube. And after that, connect this tube to this other end. So we have water in our system. After this, we need to attach this tube. So what you need to do is press it till the end and fix it. We need to fix this syringe here facing this side. Now we have excess of water in our system, so we will remove this water. So after putting it complete 10, remove this tube, water will not go. So whatever this excess water in this syringe, in 20 ml syringe, we will make it zero like this and just arrange the tubing like this. Take it from this side and fix it on a tube here. So just arrange this properly in such a way that this syringe we have to rest in the center. So if you press it like this, this will be imbalanced, and even you cannot place it like this, so it will be in the center. Take both side tape, put it there and fix it in such a way that this piston will have some margin, so that you can, before fixing, you can just adjust it. So if you press from this side, this piston will go and touch the wheel, and when you pull it back, it will come back. So just keep some margin between wheel and this piston. and in that position we have to lock this syringe using this cable tag. If you see this cable tag, from one side it is smooth and from other side it has grooves. So insert cable tag from one hole now in such a way that smooth side is facing down and this locking side is on the top. Insert it through this. Now you will hear a noise if it is locking. So just see here. So if it is making a sound, it means it is locking. And in the position, just lock this and cut the extra portion. Your hydraulic brake is ready. This wheel starts moving and you can stop it. Even you can put this cable tag on motor also. So I'm just inserting it and tight it. With a motor and also cut this. We will see how it works. So I'm making this wheel on. So this wheel is moving. You put on a brake. So even with a little push of your pedal or foot, you're stopping a big car. Just imagine, is it possible to stop a car, running car, by just your hand or by just lifting your foot? No. You cannot stop a car with your hand. But you can stop a big car by just putting a small foot on the pedal, a brake pedal. How it is possible? So you have a lever, that force is magnified using hydraulic system which stops the car. So normally we will see this by very simple demonstration. So when you put on this brake, this will create a friction and this wheel will stop. And when you lift your foot again back, your car will start moving. So this is how our regular traditional brake works. Even your cycle brake works. But when you put brake very hard, you hear a noise on road. Because your tire suddenly stops and your car or your bicycle start skidding on the road. Which creates, because see what happens normally. When this wheel is moving, this wheel has two types of motion. Can you tell me which two types of motion this wheel has? First of all, this wheel is moving around its axis, so it has rotational motion. But it is not moving only on one position around its axis. It is also moving in forward or backward direction. So that is a linear motion. So when your car is moving in this direction, these wheels are moving, so they have rotational motion. At the same time, your car is moving in forward direction, so that is linear motion. What happens when you put brakes suddenly? As Newton's laws, every object has inertia. So if your car is moving in this direction, this car will have tendency to move in the same direction. So these wheels are moving. When you put on brake, what you are stopping? You are stopping the rotational motion. But the linear motion which this car has always try to go in the same direction. So your wheels are stopped, but car is moving. And that is the major reason of accidents. So even you put a brake, you go and hit the whatever barricade or whatever it may be. That is a skidding of car. Car skids. In normal car or in normal brake system, you can't avoid such accidents. Even I will explain you with this wheel. So this wheel is moving. So you're moving in this direction. So this wheel is pointed towards you. Now what happens? When you see something in front of you, you put on the brakes. Your wheel stops, but you move in this direction. And you hit the wall or barricade, whatever it may be. Even you... Of course, we have steering in our hand. Many a times what happens, you see something in front of your car, you put on the brakes, you change the direction of wheel. What happens? So I'm changing the direction of wheel and putting on a brake. So my brakes, your steering in is this direction and your car, in which direction your car will move? Tell me. Even you, your steerings are in this direction, your car will move in this direction because this motion has stopped on road. So even if your car wheels are in this direction by putting a steering, if they are stopped, your car will move in forward direction and you will hit the things. In anti-brake system, see, to stop car, what is important? The forces, they should be equal. So, in which direction the car is moving and you are stopping the wheel, if they are in same direction, then you can control the speed of car. And that is the beauty of ABS system, anti-lock braking system. So, in anti-lock braking system, basically that car has sensors. So, what happens? I will just explain you. Also, I'm going to show you one video on this. So, you put on a brake. So, you change the direction. In this direction, now what happens? Car will skid in this direction. So, sensors will sense the change in direction. They will release this wheel for some time. So, car will start, instead of going in this direction, car will move in this direction for some time. Then again you put on the brake, car will skid in this direction, but again if you are steering in this direction, wheels are in this direction. So for those some fractions of seconds, that sensor system allows wheels to move even you put on the brake. So those wheels move for some time, car changes its orientation or path and you avoid the accidents. And the distance is also shortest for stoppage. So just this is very wonderful system, ABS system in your car. So if your car don't have ABS system, make sure that when you buy next time new car, make sure that you have ABS system to prevent from accident. That is how hydraulic brakes are working. Hope you have enjoyed this system and you will explore, I request you to explore in this system more and more. And if you have any doubts or questions, you can always call us. Thank you.